Rachel and I really like to use these little wheelie desks on the daybed with the computers, and I'd like to make some drawers to go underneath them. And I even made a drawer like that before, but the problem with these desks is they go underneath the bed, so I need a drawer that doesn't touch the floor. As usual, I'm starting this project with some used lumber I picked up from the garbage, and here I'm cutting that into strips to use for my drawers. I glued some of the scraps side by side to get enough width for the drawers. It seems to be fashionable to take new wood and make it look old and banged up, but I like to go against fashion, so I'm taking my old wood and planing it down a bit to make it look newer. And as usual, I'm joining the corners with my Screw Advance box joint jig. I usually run it without a table saw insert so that I suck a little bit more dust down the saw, and I'm making quarter inch joints and just using a regular table saw blade by making multiple cuts. The pieces of tape on the gear tell me where I need to stop to make the cuts. So here's the sides and back of my big drawer, and the front needs to go on to form a bit of a T-joint like this. So I could cut a series of mortises for this joint, but what I'm doing instead is I cut a really deep set of box joints on here. Now that leaves a whole lot of gaps here, but this was actually my sacrificial backer from cutting these joints, and I just need to stick that in here, and that'll fill all the gaps. Before I put it together, I need to put a rabbet in the bottom of the front. This groove will allow me to attach the bottom of the drawer later. Now I'm just going to put glue between all the fingers and I can assemble those front joints. And the clamping square helps to keep it all square while I work on the rest of that drawer. An extra comb piece glued into the end of that joint fills it in. Most of that comb gets cut off on the table saw. It's just more convenient to glue it in as a comb instead of individual pieces. Now I'm ripping some mahogany veneer to go on the front. I like to do that on the table saw instead of the bandsaw if I can reach across it from both sides, using a 7¼-inch blade, because it makes a very thin kerf, and the cut is smooth and precise enough that I don't have to do that much to it to get the final surface. Now the mahogany that I had wasn't quite wide enough, so I have to join two pieces edge to edge to make a full width veneer for the drawer. I'm using my long reach C-clamps to make sure that the layers stay lined up in the middle. I'm using a scrap of wood to spread the glue on the front and on the veneer. That way I don't have a glue roller or a glue brush that I need to worry about cleaning afterwards. I'm using a scrap of carpeting to spread the clamping force all over the front, and then a board on top of that, and then lots and lots of clamps. After applying all the clamps, I go through all of them and tighten them a little bit more. I used a hand plane to flush trim the veneer to the drawer. I could have used a machine for that, but it wasn't worth setting up. And then I used my reverse scoring trick to cut off the ends of the veneer without getting any chip out on the front. I made two drawers 80 by 85 centimeters, but the plywood comes in 150 by 150 centimeter sheets, and there's no way to get two of those out of that without overlapping a bit, so I decided to just have the corner missing from one of them. I used a 45 degree cut for gluing in the piece that was missing. I figured that way I get a slightly stronger glue joint. And now I'm ready to glue the bottom on. The glue is what mostly holds it on, but I'm also putting in a row of brad nails just to be on the safe side and also to hold it together while the glue dries. I made some brackets to hold the drawer slides, and those clamp to the angle iron that the slats actually rest on, so that way I can easily slide them in place. Pushing these drawer slides closed for the first time is always a bit of a challenge. Now I just need to put the slats and the mattress back in place, and it's almost done.
My initial plan was to just open the drawers by reaching underneath them, but then a few days later I ended up putting drawer handles on there. But the cool thing is the drawers aren't completely full of junk yet. It's like there's still virgin storage space.